If it's all right, we gonna talk. And the topic tonight is there's a time and season to all things. Ain't that the truth? It's a time and season to all things. We might not believe it. We may not want to accept it. But there's a time and a season to all things. Let's go to Ecclesiastes. Praise God. We're going to Ecclesiastes chapter 3. Talking about a time and season to all things.
Amen.
Ecclesiastes chapter 3. It says, to everything there is a season and a time to every purpose under the sun. A time to be born. Right?
Amen.
Somebody go to John. John chapter 3. Can I get some preachers to help me read so we can speed it up?
Amen.
We're going to talk about this tonight. It's a time for everything. It's a time for everything.
I need a couple of y'all. Okay.
All right. Okay. Somebody go in to John chapter 3. And whoever's getting John chapter 3, the next person go to Romans chapter 6. I told Pastor Jay, we're going to hit it and run tonight. We ain't playing. It's a time to go home, man. Time to come to church. It's a time to go home. Told me you better text somebody, see if we still here. Because we ain't playing with it tonight. It's a time and season to what? To all things. Somebody got John chapter 3? Go ahead and start reading with verse 3 for me.
There was a man of the Pharisees named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews.
Right.
The same came to Jesus by night and said unto him, Rabbi, we know that thou art a teacher come from God, for no man can do these miracles that thou doest except God be with him. Jesus answered and said unto him, verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born again.
Wait a minute. Hold on. He says a time to be born, right?
Amen.
We all thank God for being here in the natural, for being born on whatever our date of birth was.
Yes.
But you got to be born again.
Yes.
See, my birthday was March the 15th, 1979. Thank God for it.
Amen.
But guess what? I had to be born again.
Amen.
So by 19 years into it, I became born again.
Yeah.
So everything that happened before them 19 years, it don't count.
Right.
Go ahead, what he said?
He cannot see the kingdom of God.
You can't see the kingdom of God, or what else?
Nicodemus said unto him, how can a man be born when he is old?
Wait a minute here. How can I be born again when I'm old? Now, Nicodemus finna jump corner on him. We ain't even finna play with Nicodemus tonight. He got corner. He thought Jesus was talking about going back into his mother's womb. Jesus wasn't talking about that. He was talking about something spiritual. You know, you got to get your mind out the flesh when something spiritual coming. Because if you're in the flesh, you ain't going to be able to comprehend what Jesus is saying. So Jesus had to break it down to him. No, Nicodemus, that ain't what we talking about. Go ahead.
Can he enter the second time into his mother's womb and be born?
No.
Jesus answered, verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born of the water and of the spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God.
There we have it. Except you be born of the water and the spirit, you can't enter into the kingdom of God. So you got to be born by water through baptism, and you got to be born in the spirit, and you got to be filled with the Holy Ghost, right? So Ecclesiastes said there's a time to be born, and he said there's a time to die, and the next one said a time to plant. Who got Romans? 6:4.
Therefore, we are buried with him by baptism into death, that like as Christ was raised up from the dead by the glory of the Father, even so we also shall walk in newness of life.
Right? Keep going.
For if we have been planted together in the likeness of his death, we shall be also in the likeness of his resurrection.
Right.
Knowing this, that our old man is crucified with him, that the body of sin might be destroyed, that henceforth we shall not serve sin.
That's right. Go to 7.
For he that is dead is free from sin.
All right. So it says a time, you know, to be planted. So just like Jesus came, he was born, and then he died, and he stayed in the grave on the third day, and then he was raised up. He was raised up on the third day. We got to die to sin. So we are planted together in his likeness. I mean, just like Jesus, the whole process that he went through, now we got to do that today. We got to be planted in his likeness, and we got to die to sin. Ain't no, that sound all right?
Amen.
So a time to plant and a time to pluck up that which is planted. And verse 3 says a time to kill. Somebody go to Psalms. No. Go to Romans 8. And then I'm going to read Psalms while y'all going. They said, blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor sinning in the seat of the scornful. And then verse 2 says, but his delight is in the law of the Lord, and his law does he meditate day and night, and ye shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water. That's dealing with a time to plant. Planted by the rivers of water that bringeth forth his fruit in what? His season. We got to understand that God got it worked out for us. Everything is going to come to pass in his season. So in the meantime, we need to meditate on God's word when? Day and night. Just keep meditating on the word. While you waiting on that thing to come to pass, just keep meditating. You know, sometimes you can get some news that may shatter your spirit a little bit. That's all right. Just pick up the book. Keep reading. Keep meditating. Praise God. And just be planted by the rivers of water. You're going to bring forth that fruit in the right season. Now, Romans, we talk about a time to kill. Romans 8, verse 35. Somebody read that. Romans 8. Go ahead.
8:35. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ?
Right.
Shall tribulation?
No.
Or distress?
No.
Or persecution?
No.
Or famine?
No.
Or nakedness?
Nothing.
Or peril?
Go ahead.
Or sword?
No.
As it is written, for thy sake we are killed all the day long.
Right.
We are counted as sheep for the slaughter.
Yes.
Nay, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him that loved us.
That's right. I like that. And I went to that we are killed all the day long. Don't it seem like sometimes by the time you come out of one trial, here come another trial. By the time you get rid of this, here come that. By the time you shut the door to that, this right here comes. But we killed all the day long. All these things is making us. It's not breaking us, it's making us. It's making us, it's molding us to what God is calling us to be. So it said we killed all the day long. We are counted as sheep going to the slaughter. Sometimes you feel like you slaughtered. Sometimes you feel like, you know, you can't even catch a breath. But that's all right. We're more than conquerors. We're more than, do you know what that means? More than conquerors. My God, that's a blessing right there. So we don't have to be concerned about anything that presents itself to us in the natural. Ain't that a blessing?
Amen.
Okay, so it says we dealt with a time to kill and a time to, let's go to a time to heal. All right, so James chapter 5, it says, confess your faults one to another and pray one for another that you may be healed. And I like this verse because it's interchangeable. It switches over. It means A got to be done in order for B to take place.
Yes.
Okay? It says, confess your faults one to another and pray one for another.
Yes.
That says, you got to do this in order for the healing to come first. Ah, yada. Sometimes some healers ain't going to come forth until you confess.
Yes.
Sometimes some healers, it's going to be delayed until you get that thing right with the person that you need to get it right with.
Yes.
Do you see how that's interchangeable, how it transitions into the healing?
Yeah.
No, you ain't gonna just go and talk to the Lord about something you need a healing about. You got some mess going on with somebody.
Come on.
Hello. Hello. So we gotta make sure that we got everything clean. Right?
Amen.
We gotta make sure that there's nothing between us and no human being. Right?
Amen.
And then we can get the healing. So we can expect our healing. Confess your faults one to another, then do what? Pray for one another. If you don't have anything else to pray about, call every saint in the church name.
Yes.
Call all the babies. If you don't know that name, describe them. The one that wear the ponytail like this. The one that, hey, the one that do that. The one that do that. And pray for one another.
Yes.
You may not know all the saints' names. You might not hang with all the saints at one time. But you can pray for them.
Amen.
You can say, I pray for the whole ministry. city. See what I'm saying? Pray for one another. Confess your faults one to another and pray for one another that you may be healed. And what does it say? The effectual, fervent prayer of a righteous man does what?
Avail
much. It's going to work. Prayer changes things.
Amen.
All right, so we talked about a time to kill, a time to heal, a time to break down. And when I got to time to break down, I thought about Hosea. And it says, sow to yourselves in righteousness. It says, reap in mercy. It says, break up your fallow ground. For it's time to seek the Lord till he rain down righteousness upon us. My God, that's some super duper prayer right there. It says, it's time. It says, break up your fallow ground. That means get up all that stuff about you. That means, I'm talking about get real, get right with God. And seek the Lord until he rain down righteousness upon you. Seek the Lord until he start, until you look like you're standing in front of a mirror and you see everything, bitterness, hatred, strife, whatever it is that's not like God. Hey, the more you pray, the more you see it, and the more you begin to repent and ask God, forgive me, Lord God, create me a clean heart, and renew me a right spirit. Hey, God, have mercy on me, Lord God. It's time to seek the Lord until he rain righteousness. I want God to rain righteousness. Ground. So we dealt with breakdown and a time to build up, a time to weep. You know, it's a time, and another thing with building up, sometimes we got to build each other up. Sometimes we need to be able to pull a sister or brother to the side and build them up. Tell them something encouraging. Get them a word that it ain't got to be a dust said, Lord, I just want to tell you God is good. I just want to tell you God love you. I just want to tell you I love you. I just want to tell you I've been thinking about you. Time to build up. Ain't that good?
Amen.
A time to weep. What the Bible say? Weeping may endure for a night, but what?
Joy.
Joy come in the morning. Yeah. Now I'm quoting this on Wednesday night. Now don't get up Thursday morning saying, Mama J said it's gonna happen in the morning. Now don't get it twisted. It's gonna happen in his time. Morning is his time. It says he makes all things beautiful in his time. So joy gonna come in the morning. But guess what? In his presence is the what?
Fullness of joy.
Okay, did anybody catch that?
Yes.
So your morning can be as soon as you want it.
Yes.
That means I can have joy no matter what's going on. All I got to do is tap into the presence of God. Right. That means hey, the storm be coming from the left to the right, from the front to the back. And hey, how I get in the presence of God? That's my joy.
Yes.
That's my joy.
Yes.
That's what peace that passes all understanding is.
Yes.
That means it don't make sense for you to have peace when this right here is happening. But when you get into the presence of God, I'm going to have some peace. Because I can't do nothing about this. It's time to stop meditating and focusing on stuff you can't change. That's what keeps us in the flesh all the time. We focus on what we can't change. You can't do nothing about it. You can't fix it. Unless you got a connection, unless you know some way that you can fix it, take it to God and pray. We talking about good stuff tonight?
Yeah.
All right, so it says, a time to weep, a time to laugh. Now listen at this. Psalm says, sing unto the Lord, O ye saints of his, and give thanks at the remembrance of his holiness.
Yeah.
What you say? It says, sing unto the Lord, O ye saints of his, and give thanks at the remembrance of his holiness. For his anger endureth but a moment. His favor is life. Weeping may endure for a night, and joy cometh in the morning. A time to laugh. When the Lord turned again the captivity of Zion, this is Psalms 126. We were like them that dream. Then was our mouth filled with laughter, and our tongue was singing. Then they said among the heathen, the Lord hath done great things for them. The Lord hath done great things for us, whereof we are glad. Tuka was singing today again in the highway. Better for me before church tonight. So guess what? God got better for you. Don't worry about it. He got better for you. Whatever the situation is tonight, he's got better for you. It's his will that we prosper and be in health even as I would soul prosper. See, I'm happy about talking in tongues. I'm talking about being filled with the Holy Ghost.
I'm happy about being baptized in Jesus' name. Yeah. I'm happy about all of that. But God said he will, it's his will for us to prosper.
Yeah.
Okay? So it's not going to be the same at all times. Sometimes you might have to live from paycheck to paycheck. But you got to learn to be content in whatever state that you're in.
Yeah.
But in the process of time, God will fix that thing. Yeah. Well, you got to let break. You can catch a break. You feel a little ease. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Trouble don't last always. Don't let the devil trick you. Trouble don't last always. We do not serve a God that does not know when to take it off.
Yeah.
God knows